The Obamacare website reportedly linked to malicious developers from the country of Belarus, which is a Russian ally intent on hijacking your computer information. And equally disturbing, our intel leaders don't know anything about it.
Are you aware of the report that was withdrawn?
I am not.
Director Comey, are you aware of this report?
This is the first I've heard of the matter.
And Director Flynn, are you aware of this report that was issued last week to the Obama administration?
I am not.
So no one at the table is aware of this report that was issued last week. I find this outrageous.
One thing I've learned, Congresswoman, over the years is not to believe everything I read in the media.
Okay, so are these threats from Belarus legitimate, and how can intel leaders know nothing about them? Senior editor for the Washington Free Beacon, Bill Gertz, wrote the bombshell report, and he joins us live from D.C. Good morning, Bill.
Good morning, Steve. Good to be on the show.
Okay, so tell us what sort of software from people from Belarus might be in our affordable healthcare website.
Yeah, this is an important story. Last week, intelligence officials told me that this was a serious matter, and this was based on some statements by a Belarusian official who said, our software is now on every hospital computer and healthcare network in America. And that raised alarms, and the U.S. intelligence community urged the Department of Health and Human Services to conduct a review to find out if somewhere in the 5 million lines of code they had planted some trapdoors or other software that would allow for cyber espionage, privacy data loss, and other cyber threats.
Who put it in there?
Well, it's not clear. They're looking for developers. They're looking for subcontractors. You know, I contacted the Centers for Medicaid and Medicare Services, which is in charge of developing the software, and they wouldn't release the list of some 55 subcontractors. So the suspicion is that perhaps one of these subcontractors, maybe a U.S. subsidiary of a Belarusian firm, could have been involved in it. Again, the search is not done. So far, they haven't found any malware, but again, they got a lot of code to be looking at.
Sure. Okay, so maybe, we're not sure yet, but maybe they did do this on purpose. What would the people from Belarus or Russia be able to get from our website then?
Well, I talked to Congressman Mike Rogers, the chairman of the House Intelligence Committee, and he said that the real concern here is that the healthcare network is connected to seven different hubs within the federal government. He said if you can get past one of the firewalls in the healthcare.gov site, you can get into sensitive databases, including the IRS and Department of Homeland Security. So that's really the threat.
We just ran those sound bites of Congresswoman Bachman talking to our intel people. You know, we've seen in the past where they have misrepresented the truth in public, but it looks like they didn't have any idea this was going on.
Well, I think somebody on that panel is not telling the truth. My suspicion is it has to do with CIA. This report was produced by a group based at the CIA, and it's clear that what the message was here, this was undermining a major policy program of the president, and they immediately withdrew the report. I interviewed Congresswoman Bachman yesterday, and she said she's going to pursue this. She suspects there may have been some politicization of intelligence.
That's just crazy. And a couple of days ago, when Bill O'Reilly talked to the president about the Affordable Care Act website, he said, yeah, there are a few glitches in it, but everything's fine. He didn't mention the Russians might actually have put code in there. That kind of would have been a headline.
Absolutely. Yeah, I asked the White House, was the president aware of this search for Belarusian malware? And they didn't respond to my questions.
Yeah, I wouldn't look for a call anytime soon. Bill Gertz, great reporting. Thank you very much for telling us about it on this Wednesday morning.